I'm dying here. I can't breathe. Are really, really hard words to hear, and I hope we don't get to hear them ever again. Hello, my name is Andres Ordonez, and this is Anatomy of an Ad. Yeah, the city of Chicago is one of our clients. We work very close to them, and we try to help to make a better city every day in many ways. The brief was make everyone count during census and during voting. But when you look at numbers, I believe it's 1 out of 5 Americans are not registered to vote. That's a huge number. But at the same time, the same people are always walking the streets asking for change. So George Floyd happened. The minute that George Floyd happened, anger, injustice, messages of hope went out into the streets. Everything started showing up. So every store had to close their doors and started putting these plywoods to protect their stores.
I'm gonna die here. I'm gonna die, man.
You need to take a seat.
I can't breathe.
Overnight, Minneapolis on fire.
You are more the people you're supposed to protect.
Damage was widespread. Windows shattered. Many businesses now boarded up.
We were talking about how to drive people to registration and voting and everything. And the idea came about, what if we turn these boards into voting booths? So we went to the city of Chicago. We talked to Mayor Lori Lightfoot, and she was like, go. It was just like instantly. She knew the power that will have and the drive that it will do into our communities. Then the thing was, go run and get them, because the boards, by the time we were meeting, they were starting to come down and they were about to be thrown away. Treating the boards was something incredible, and you see it on the case study, because we had to understand, we had to look at every single board, and we had 150 of those, to make sure, how do we cut them so we don't cut it the wrong way? It was not about a piece from this and a piece of that, and it was not a Tetris. It was more about understanding the message will stay there in its pure form, because the reason for them to exist is that when you would see them out into the world, it will make you stop and remind you what a couple of months ago you just went through. And in order for you to make sure that that doesn't go up again, you have to do something.
The irony, these boards were on windows of storefronts because people knocked out the windows because they felt like they didn't have a voice. And now he's turned them into a voting pool.
And I think you hear it from the community, and I think you should just play how it is. But he said, it's the irony that it was something that had this kind of energy and it was turning to something and actually giving you hope that, you know what, register and we can win this fight. We can turn this into positive. We can make something out of this.
There's a constant attack on the civil rights of Black voters in this country.
This moment now is an opportunity for us to channel this energy into constructive, lasting, democratic engagement.
1 in 5 eligible people in this country are not even registered to vote.
And then media. Media was incredible. They started picking it up. They realized the power that these boards were, and started being used in different places, showcase and others. So artists started to show up. Michelle Obama was talking about it. So it was really, really nice how, again, media and everyone started showing up to support boards of change.
I will be one of the examples that say, yes, we do have a voice.
Gotta get on board.
Now's the time.
Demand a transformation.
And then we started recording people, and people started putting it on their social media. They were next to the board. They will share it. It was a sign from their own communities. And they were just saying, time to vote, time to vote. It was not the politicians and the usual suspects trying to drive, but it was the people in your community saying, let's do it. Let's make sure this doesn't happen. Let's make sure history doesn't repeat itself. So suddenly they started living in different channels.
A systemic transformation, and that we have a seat at the table.
getting out the vote. Kevin
it's called Boards of Change.
Boards of Change.
The Chicago Board of Elections is expecting record-breaking turnout.
Creativity has the power to fuel change. But if that change cannot be measured in impact, we're just talking to ourselves. And I think the beauty of the Boards of Change is that we saw an 8% lift in registration, which is a lot. And we people understood the importance of voting. And now the boards live on a museum, on the African American Museum in Chicago. And they still have information about it. So actually, if you go through the Dusable Museum, you can scan the code and you can learn about the history of those booths. So they will always keep reminding every person in our town or in our city the importance of registration and voting.